Hello friends, I am RM Garud, working as assistant professor in Sri Lanka Technology College of Engineering. Today we are going to see theories in urban and regional planning. This is module number 1. First of all, in this slide we are going to see what is urban planning. The design and regulation of the houses of space that focus on the physical form, economic functions and social impacts of the urban environment and on the location of different activities within. This involves goal setting, data collection and analysis, forecasting, design, strategic thinking and public consultation. These actors have main role in urban planning, the decision makers and the technicians. So this slide refers to introduction to urban planning, in which we are going to consider the spatial means space related concepts, in which the urbanization is the movement of population from rural to urban areas. A theory is an organized system of accepted knowledge that applies in a variety of circumstances to explain a specific set of phenomena. The urbanization is a relatively new global issue. In 1950, only 30% of the world population was living in urban area and 50% in 2009. The big question is, how to do towns come about to be? This slide refers to history of urban planning. The first recorded description of urban planning is described in the Epic of Gilgamesh. Design cities were characteristics of Minoan, Mesopotamian, Harappan and Egyptian civilization of the ancient period. As per Aristotle, Hippopotamus invented the vision of cities. Therefore, he was called the father of urban planning in the 5th century BC. Ideal city centrally planned in the 15th century. In 1876, the term unurbanization pulled by Ildefons Cerdá due to the reconstruction process. This slide refers to grid model, that is Hippodamian plan for city of Prin, proposed by Hippodamus of Miletus, who is considered the father of rational city planning. The center of city contains the agora, that is marketplace, theaters and temples. Private rooms surround the city's public arena. The plan can be laid out uniformly over any kind of terrain since it is based on angles and measurements. The modern urban planning and architecture went through a paradigm shift at the turn of the 20th century. The industrialized cities of the 19th century had grown at a tremendous rate, with the pace and style of building largely dictated by private business concerns. The evils of urban life for the working poor were becoming increasingly evident as a matter for public concern. This slide refers to modern urban planning. As per the planning theorist Paul Knox, the profession of planning emerges out of a series of crises and people's responses to them, which include health crisis, social crisis and other crises. Health crises include epidemics, social crises include riots and strikes, and other crises include fire and floods. Urban planning is a response to these crises or problems. So as per the Benjamin Ward Richardson, who wrote The Hygeria, City of Health, consisting of air pollution control, water purification, sewage handling, public health inspectors, replacement of gutter with park as the site of children's play, such concerns motivated the parks movement. The naturalistic parks were created in the US by Frederick Law, Central Park being the first New York in 1857. Modern urban theories were put forth by the different eminent personalities since 1883 to 1945. They were linear city, garden cities, region city, radiant city, concentric zone theory, the neighborhood unit theory, red burn city, central place theory, broad acre city, sector theory and multiple nuclei theory. The linear city is proposed for a town of 30,000 people based upon the principal transport route, which is 100 meter wide of infinite length depending upon urban growth. All services channelized along the street. Other community facilities group at regular intervals. It considers residential area is limited to 200 meter either side beyond which would lie the countryside. The linear city gears away from the usual centric urban forms. The lines help control the expansion of a city. This slide refers to grid model, that is Hippodamian plan. This slide refers to modern urban planning. As per the planning theorist Paul Knox, the profession of planning emerges out of series of crises and people's responses to them, which include health crisis, social crisis, and other crises. Health crises include epidemics, social crises include riots and strikes, and other crises include fire and floods. Urban planning is a response to these crises or problems. So as per the Benjamin Ward Richardson, who wrote The Hegeria, City of Health, modern urban theories were put forth by the different eminent personalities since 1883 to 1945. They were linear city, garden cities, region city, radiant city, concentric zone theory, the neighborhood unit theory, Redburn city, central place theory, Broadacre city, sector theory, and multiple nuclei. The linear city is proposed for a town of 30,000 people based upon the principal transport route, which is 100 meter wide of infinite length depending upon urban growth. All services channelized along the street. Other community facilities group at regular intervals. It considers residential area is limited to 200 meter either side. This slide refers to grid model, that is Hippodamian plan for city of Crete, proposed by Hippodamus of Miletus, who is considered the father of rational city planning. The center of city contains the agora, that is marketplace, theaters and temples. Private rooms surround the city's public arena. The plan can be laid out uniformly over any kind of terrain since it is based on angles. This slide refers to modern urban planning. As per the planning theorist Paul Knox, the profession of planning emerges out of series of crises and people. So as per the Benjamin Ward Richardson, who wrote The Hegeria, City of Health, consisting of air pollution control, water purification, sewage handling, public health inspectors, replacement of gutter with park as the site of children's play, such concern motivated the parks movement. The naturalistic parks were created in the US by Frederick Law, Central Park being modern urban theories were put forth by the different eminent personalities since 1883 to 1945. They were linear city. The linear city is proposed for a town of 30,000 people based upon the principal transport route, which is 100 meter wide of infinite length depending upon urban growth. All services channelized along the street. Other community facilities group at regular intervals. It considers residential area is limited to 200 meter either side beyond which would lie the countryside. The linear city gears away from the usual centric urban forms. The lines help control the expansion of a city. This slide refers to grid model, that is Hippodamian plan for city of Crete, proposed by Hippodamus of Miletus, who is considered the father of rational city planning. The center of city contains the agora, that is marketplace, theaters and temples. Private rooms surround the city's public area. This slide refers to modern urban planning. As per the planning theorist Paul Knox, the profession of planning emerges out of series of crises and people's responses to them, which include health crisis, social crisis, and other crises. Health crises include epidemics, social crisis. The central place theory considers the relationship between city, village, town, and hamlet. The central place theory proposed by Christelius in the year 1933. It states that the range of good and threshold population of retail shops and service establishments are the major influences in explaining the number, size and distribution pattern of settlement. And the finding of this theory was, consumers avoid higher transport cost by going to the nearest service location. The larger the settlement in size, the fewer in number they will be. The more number of settlements, the higher order of services and the higher the degree of specialization that occurs. It provides an economic and spatial development of regions through provision of appropriate goods and services with establishments according to scale. Then the next theory is Brodecker City Theory. The highlight points are low density, car oriented, freeway plus feeder roads and multi-nuclei concept. The Brodecker City Theory, in which involvement of communities, and it is designed for 1000 hectares. It is included the social services in the form of schools, trains and museums, as well as employment in the form of markets, offices, nearby farms and industrial area. Then the next theory is sector theory, developed in 1939 by land economist Homer Hoyt. It is a model of an internal structure of cities. Social groups are arranged around a series of sectors or wedges radiating out from central business district, that is CBD, and centered on major transportation line. Sector theory includes low-income households to be near railroad lines and commercial establishment to be along the business thoroughfares. The central place theory considers the relationship between city, village, town and hamlet. The central place theory, proposed by Christelius in the year 1933, it states that the range of good and threshold population of retail shops and service establishments. Then the next theory is Brodecker City Theory. The highlight points are low density, car oriented, freeway plus feeder roads and multi-nuclei concept. The next model is Homer Hoyt's sector model. He proposes in the year 1939. Again, he considers central business district, wholesale light manufacturing, outlying business district, low class residential, medium class residential, high class residential, residential suburb, heavy manufacturing and industrial suburb. This slide refers to grid model, that is Hippodamian plan for city of Prin, proposed by Hippodamus of Miletus, who is considered the father of rational city planning. The center of city contains the agora, that is marketplace, theaters and temples. This slide refers to multiple nuclei theory. The multiple nuclei model is an ecological model created by Harris and Edward Ullman in the year 1945. As the city grows from several independent points rather than from one central business district, as these expand, they merge to form a single urban area. Ports, universities, airports and parks also act as nodes, based on the idea that people have greater movement due to increased car ownership. The multiple nuclei theory has four geographic principles. Certain activities require highly specialized facilities, accessible transportation for a factor, larger areas of open land for housing transition. Certain activities cluster because they profit from mutual association, Certain activities repel each other and will not be found in the same area. Certain activities could not make a profit if they paid the high rent of the most desirable locations. This slide refers multiple nuclear cities put forth by Harris Ullman, in which central business district, wholesale light manufacturing, low-class residential, medium-class residential, high-class residential, heavy manufacturing, outlying business district, residential suburb and industrial suburb were proposed. This theory stresses the importance of multiple nodes of activity, not a single CBD. Ports, airports, universities attract certain users while repelling others. The next model is Homer Hoyt's sector model. He proposes in the year 1939. Again, he considers central business district, wholesale light manufacturing, outlying business district, low class residential, medium class residential, high class residential, residential suburb, heavy manufacturing and industrial suburb. This is first theory, that is push and pull, which is used in the town planning. The push and pull theory considers environmental, social and economical as well as political factors and other factors they considers were poverty, fear, disaster, unemployment, and the pull factors are safety, opportunity, stability and freedom. The central place theory considers the relationship between city, village, town and hamlet. This slide refers to Von Thunen's model of agricultural land use, in which he proposes the urban center and the market at the central place, and it is surrounded by dairy farming and market gardening. Again, the dairy farming and market gardening is surrounded by the forest, and the forest sector is surrounded by grain and field crops, and field crops is surrounded by ranching and livestock, showing their interrelationship between the agricultural land use. Then the next theory is broad acre city theory. The highlight points are low density, car oriented, freeways plus feeder roads and multi-nuclei concept. This slide refers to least cost theory of industrial location. It is proposed by Weber in the year 1959. It considers the three elements. One is thirsty town, second is hops and grain field, and third is mountain spring, and their interrelationship. This slide refers to modern urban planning. As per the planning theorist Paul Knox, the profession of planning emerges out of series of crises and people's responses to them, which include health crisis, social crisis and other crises. Health crises include epidemics, social crises include riots and strikes, and other crises include fire and floods. Urban planning is a response to these crises or problems. This slide refers to theory of land rent. This theory considers the various sectors such as retail, manufacturing and residential and their distances from the central business district and their effect on land uses. This slide refers to theory of land rent as the bid rent function proposed by Alons in the year 1964. The theory states that the price of land and demand for land changes according to distance from the central business district. The center commands the highest value of land because of its proximity to business establishment and support services as well as the market. Provided an explanation on why slums and squatter settlements proliferate in areas close to the CBD or commercial centers. Then the next theory was the law of migration. It is put forth by Ravenstein in the year 1885. It is regarding the currents of migration. The broad acre city theory in which involvement of communities, and it is designed for 1000 hectares. It is included the social services in the form of schools, trains and museums, as well as employment in the form of markets, offices, nearby farms and industrial area. Modern urban theories were put forth by the different eminent personalities since 1883 to 1945. They were linear city, garden cities, region city, radiant city, concentric zone theory, the neighborhood unit theory, Redbourn city, central place theory, broad acre city, sector theory and multiple nuclei. Then the next theory is by the Todaros, migration in developing countries. Migration is an economic dimension of rural dwellers, where individual and household members believe that there is a higher expected income in urban areas. This slide refers to urban environmental transition theory proposed by McGrath. He considers the plot of increasing severity versus increasing wealth, showing poor settlement and wealthy settlement, and the shifting environmental burdens from local to global, immediate to delayed, threaten health directly to threaten life support system. This slide refers to McGrath's 2009 Urban Environmental Transition Theory, in which the development and environmental has been shown by the environmental Cousinet curve, where that as the development progresses, the environmental degrades. This slide is a plot of environmental degradation versus per capita income, where the environmental worsens and environment improves, and the turning point is shown. So, as per the Benjamin Ward Richardson, who wrote The Hygeria, City of Health, consisting of air pollution control, water purification, sewage handling, public health inspectors, replacement of gutter with park as the site. Thank you, friends, for your patient listening.